Hello my friends, it is your brother Hampton from Hybrid Calisthenics, here to make a video on how to do a push-up. There are some people that tell me they can't do push-ups, and they seem almost ashamed of it. There's really nothing to be ashamed of. There's a lot of really strong people nowadays that once couldn't do a push-up. And second, I would not recommend to just keep trying to do push-ups until you get it. While this can sometimes work, and you hear this a lot in training camps and boot camps sometimes, this is similar to telling someone who can't bench press, say, 125 pounds to just keep trying to bench press 125 pounds and you'll get it. You might be able to, and there are different ways you can train for that, but you might also injure yourself along the way. Would it not make a lot more sense to bench press a lower weight and work your way up to 125 pounds? In a very similar vein, there are many different kinds of push-ups. There are wall push-ups, incline push-ups at different height, kneeling push-ups, and then regular push-ups. And from there, we can go on to harder push-ups. What we can and should do is find a push-up variation that we can do comfortably and safely, and work it until we can hit a certain amount of sets and reps. And when we hit that, we are strong enough to move on to the next step. I hope that makes sense so far. If you're familiar with my content, these next exercises will seem very familiar to you. The first step is a wall push-up. This is one of the easiest, if not the easiest, form of push-up. If you can't do these yet, don't worry, you're not alone. You can lie on your bed and just bench press the air. It most likely won't be a strength issue, but a joint pain issue. When doing wall push-ups, keep your hands at shoulder height. Doing them too low will bend your wrist a lot and your wrist may hurt. Do these until you can do 3 sets of 50. This means do one set of as many as you can, or 50, rest for a few minutes, do another set of as many as you can, or 50, and then repeat for a third set if you hit 50. If you stop and walk away at any moment, the set is over. The next step is incline push-ups. You can do these on a table or railing or any stable object. The lower the object, the harder the exercise. Finding something around hip height is a good start, but if you need to, you can find something higher and work your way down as you get stronger. Do these until you can do 3 sets of 40. Try not to be upset if it takes you a while to hit these goals and move on. When we're doing these exercises, we're actually building strength. When we move on to a harder exercise, all we're doing is demonstrating and using our new strength. The next step is kneeling push-ups. While our hands are finally on the floor, we're also on our knees, making this exercise slightly easier than a regular push-up. I never call these girl push-ups because frankly, there are some girls that are really strong. And plus, I've never met a girl that likes them being called that, and come on, we all have mothers. Do these until you can do 3 sets of 25, and then you should be strong enough to do at least a few regular push-ups. If you're not quite strong enough yet, don't worry, you don't have to go all the way down. Keep going lower and lower as you get stronger. Because this video is about strength and we're training to do a regular push-up, keep all your reps slow and controlled, try to resist the urge to do them fast. Momentum usually makes our exercise easier, which is not what we want for strength. That's it, it's not very complicated, it's pretty straightforward. Please take your time and remember to progress slowly, carefully, and safely. Don't think of the earlier variations as working a lesser form of push-up. Think of it as working the best exercise you can to build pushing strength. I really hope that helps. Please let me know if you have questions. This is your brother Hampton from Hybrid Calisthenics. Have a beautiful day.